You're listening to the audio production of Spart. Discover your unique imprint for work that makes you come alive by Jonathan Fields. Published by HarperCollins Leadership and read by the author. Please note that you may download an accompanying PDF that provides enhanced materials for this audiobook. To download the PDF, please visit harperfocusaudio.com. To all who feel the call to come alive, it's our time. A note from Jonathan. Hey there. Before you dive into this book, a quick heads up. You're about to discover some things about yourself, your work, and your life that'll open your eyes to an entirely new universe of possibilities. And you may also, maybe for the first time ever, find yourself deeply seen, understood, and equipped to step into the world of work in a profoundly different, deeply rewarding way. That is amazing. It's the whole point of the work that I've been doing for years, and well, a big part of why this book exists. But I have to bring your attention to something and ask a quick favor. When you start to see what's possible in the realm of work, how it can fill you with meaning, energy, excitement, purpose, and that deeply nourishing sense of realized potential, you may also have this urge to blow everything up and start fresh. Please do not do this. That approach may be appropriate for some folks, but it's often the absolute wrong call for many, even most others. And you'll likely not know which you are until you've read the book and learned when, why, and how to explore the different paths to sparking your work and life based on your unique sparketype and circumstance. Truth is, most people will discover something they never expected. You can come more fully alive right where you are by just approaching your work and life with deeper wisdom and a new set of tools. So please hold off on doing anything big and disruptive. Much will be revealed as you deepen into the insights and discover how best to spark your work and in turn, your life. Okay, now, read on. So much to discover, so much life to live into. With a whole lot of love and gratitude, Jonathan. What should I do with my life? Type "what should I do" into Google, and there's a decent chance it'll finish your sentence "with my life." If you're feeling a bit lost or have no clear sense of what you're here to do, you're not alone. Millions are right there with you, searching for an answer to the same question, yet never quite finding it. This perpetual discontent shows up in our personal and professional lives as anxiety, futility, disengagement, malaise, and manifests in many other physical and emotional ways. It affects not just how we feel, but also how we show up in our work, our relationships, and our lives. Our focus is scattered. We know we're not performing anywhere near our potential. And there's this nagging lack of purpose and possibility that feels like a perpetual drag in our systems. Maybe you felt some or all of that. We hate feeling this way. Knowing we are capable of so much more, meant for so much more, yet having no idea what that looks like, let alone how to live it. We keep searching for a way out, a different job, industry, or lifestyle, but that's not the answer. While circumstance is part of the equation, the bigger switch that often needs to be flipped is one of self-discovery. We can't know where to steer our lives until we better understand what makes us come alive and what empties us out. It all starts with one central question. What am I here to do? When most of us ask, we're thinking about work. What is my unique contribution to my life, to the lives of those around me, to society? Whether it's the thing I get paid to do or the thing once discovered, I can't not do, simply because it's the air that breathes me. What is the essential nature of work I'm here to do? This book is your first giant step into a level of understanding, validation, and for many, revelation that holds the key to a different way to approach your work, living, and life. An approach that bridges the gap from just getting by to coming alive. For more than 2 decades, I've immersed myself in the study of human potential, collaborating with and studying everyone from academic researchers to leading voices in a wide array of fields. From social sciences to functional medicine, human performance, excellence and expertise, positive psychology, and more. Along the way, I've founded and built a series of wellness companies, developed frameworks and protocols, launched and grown the Good Life Project global community, organization, and top-ranked podcast, taught thousands of students, and worked with emerging and senior leaders and amazing humans from all walks of life. All the while, I've been on a quest to discover what allows people to find or create work that makes them come alive and maximizes their potential. Working with my team over the last 5 years, we began to focus more intensely on this state I call being sparked, especially in the context of work. I've come to realize that being sparked exists at the sweet spot between 5 domains. Purpose, knowing you're moving towards something you believe in. Engagement, excitement, energy, and enthusiasm for the pursuit of that something. Meaningfulness, the feeling that what you do and who you are matters. Expressed potential, the sensation of being fully you and not having to hide, bringing all of your potential to the experience and leaving nothing untapped. Flow, the blissful experience of getting lost in an activity, losing time, and becoming absorbed in the task. Early in life, it turns out, we begin to exhibit a certain unique imprint or affinity, an intrinsic impulse for work that makes us come alive. This work gives us the feeling of being sparked. These imprints not only determine what type of work or effort we're drawn to and repelled from, they also tend to come with a host of common behaviors, quirks, and attachments. I call these imprints sparketypes, which is an easy shorthand for the source code level driver of work that makes you come alive, not just for now, but for life. For most people, discovering your sparketype is like meeting your true self. There's an immediate intuitive knowing, an undeniable truth that explains so many past choices and outcomes. It empowers you to not only understand who you are and why you do what you do, but also how you contribute to the world on a very different, more intentional, and fulfilling level. It sparks your life and ignites those around you. Discovering your sparketype is often described as a homecoming, a recognition that, yes, this is me, and it's worthy of my time, energy, and attention. While words like life purpose or singular passion often lead people down a path of confusion and futility, rather than clarity and action, finding your sparketype gives you the exact opposite. It equips you with insight that immediately rings true, a sense of direction, and the freedom to finally lead from a place of truth and potential. It allows you to let go of a lifetime of scattered and perpetually unfulfilling wheel spinning. It frees you from all the less nourishing distractions and allows you to devote your energy to finding the incredible, vast kaleidoscope of pursuits, careers, projects, and adventures that let you express your unique imprint on a level that makes you come more fully alive. You don't have to buy into any one origin story, catchphrase, or set of beliefs to experience the self-evident, sustained nature and guiding influence of your sparketype. You just have to discover yours, then weave it into the way you live and give. The feeling it gives back to you, the way those around you begin to respond when you live, play, and work from this place, will be all the validation, all the proof you need. Now, of course, a few questions immediately arise. How many Sparketypes are there? The quick answer is 10. Funny enough, we began with a slightly larger number, 7.8 billion, the number of people in the world. We're each unique, so there must also be 7.8 billion unique imprints. We cannot be distilled, right? Not so fast. Your Sparketype is a bit like your DNA. On the surface, it may express itself in billions of unique, gloriously you and only you ways. But when you start to peel each person's purpose, engagement, meaning, expression, and flow onion, billions of valid, surface-level, time-limited, circumstance-driven expressions reduce down to a remarkably small set of source code-level elements or imprints. This leaves us with 10 distinct DNA-level drivers, the Sparketypes. Maven, Maker, Scientist, Essentialist, Performer, Sage, Warrior, Advisor, Advocate, Nurturer. Your Sparketype has three elements. We're all a blend of a number of different Sparketypes, but every person has a distinct Sparketype profile that is made up of three key components. These represent your strongest impulses at both ends of the spectrum, the work that fills you up as well as empties you out. Your primary Sparketype. Think of your primary Sparketype as the thing that generates the strongest impulse to exert effort for no other reason than the fact that it makes you feel alive. It's the underlying driver or source fuel for the work that gives you the readiest access to flow, energizes and excites you, gives you a sense of meaning and purpose, and allows you to feel like you're expressing your fullest self and potential. Expressed in a healthy and constructive way, it's a big part of any number of jobs, experiences, hobbies, passions, and devotions that make you come alive, even when the work is hard. Your shadow Sparketype. Your shadow Sparketype is also a big part of you, sometimes even a close second behind your primary. It is not, however, your strongest impulse. It's easy to think of your shadow Sparketype as your runner-up Sparketype, and it may be a very close second. But while there is a lot of truth to that, a much more nuanced and important to understand relationship almost always exists between your primary and your shadow. Your shadow Sparketype most often reveals the work that you may well enjoy and have developed a high level of skill around. But when you're really being honest, it is also the work you do largely in service of doing the work of your primary Sparketype better. Think of it as your primary Sparketype amplifier. Your anti-Sparketype. Your anti-Sparketype is the type of work that is the heaviest lift for you. It takes the most out of you and requires the greatest amount of recovery, even if, objectively, it's not that hard. There's just something about it that leaves you empty as opposed to making you come alive. Your primary and shadow are your inner collaborators. I am a maker primary with a scientist shadow. This is a common pairing, as is the reverse. My main impulse, the thing that fills me up, even when it's really hard, is making things. At any given time, outward expressions of this could find me building a guitar, writing a book, or even launching a company. With every quest to create, at many points along the way, I find myself drawing upon my scientist shadow Sparketype to help me make whatever I'm working on better. There are always hard questions to be answered, puzzles to be solved, tools, systems, and more to be designed. The act of creation is often constrained by limitations in tools, processes, tech, resources, and so much more. Figuring these things out along the way is largely the work of the scientist, who is driven by the pursuit of answers to burning questions, solving problems, and figuring out puzzles. Over the years, I've become very good at the work of my scientist shadow. It's not so much that I've wanted to, it's that I had to in order to be a better maker. I tap my problem-solving impulse in the quest to make better tools, processes, and experiences that help people come alive. This is especially true for solitary pursuits or in the early days of bootstrap startups where I've had to play all roles because I didn't have the money to bring in a team yet.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.